Adobe have added a new feature to Illustrator, and I think you're going to agree with me that it's really, really useful. And I'm going to explain everything you need to know in under 5 minutes. And later in today's video, learn how you can get access to Skillshare Premium. Now, Skillshare is an online learning community with thousands of different courses across a wide range of creative areas. These are things like logo designing, just graphic design in general, web design, photography, and so much more. So yeah, stay tuned to the very end of today's video to learn more. So once you've gone ahead and updated your Illustrator CC application, you're going to find this new feature under the object and then the repeat menu. So we have three options here for us. We have the radial, the grid, and also the mirror. However, there is also an options menu, which when you click it, opens up this new window. So as you can see, we also have the same three categories of the radial, grid, and mirror into this option. This menu is going to come in handy later, but first let's check out the radial repeat function. So I have a stroked circle on my artboard, and if I click the radial repeat function, Illustrator evenly distributes my object 8 times around a circle, hence the term radial. This slider dictates the amount of circumference of the radial area that can be seen, so you can show or hide different amounts of your repeated pattern. And then this slider here adds or removes the amount of times your object is repeated. So with this function, we can have quite a lot of fun and also make things like spirograph style vectors. We can also drag this button here to bring in or out the radial line, and we are able to adjust the strokes of our design in real time. Also up here, we can adjust the size of the radial area too, and I absolutely love this style of geometric design. But let's move on to the next section, which is the grid repeat option. So I'm sure you're like me, you've probably wanted a way to repeat a design asset and then edit it thereafter. Well, the grid repeat option allows you to do just that. Once repeated, we can control how much of the repetition we want to show or hide with these sliders here. The other two sliders control the gap between our repeated pattern, which we can again change in real time. But it's also worth noting that we can adjust the color of our design as well, all while still editing the repetition. If we want to edit individual aspects of our design, expanding and then ungrouping is not going to do anything. We actually need to come into the Pathfinder window and perform something like a divide operation. And then of course, ungroup everything. This will then allow us to work on individual aspects of our pattern design. So still with the repeat grid function, let's open up that options menu we saw earlier. From this window, we can control the way in which things are orientated on the grid repeat pattern, as well as the dimensions of the thing itself in precise measurements. It's always nice to have complete control over something in Illustrator with precise numbers. So the third repeat function is the mirror repeat. And this one is pretty straightforward. You have a design and then you give yourself a mirror line to which you can then move your design around in real time. However, there are some things you need to be aware of. Now, firstly, with all of the repeat functions in today's video, it might be worth noting that you can switch on the real-time drawing option and you can then see your design move smoothly and effective around your artboard. And of course, this is open to all CC users. We can also rotate the mirror line itself. And I have found that with the mirror line, you can hold down the shift key and this will orientate your design by 90 degrees, meaning the mirror line itself moves at 45 degrees. We can also change this up here in the drop-down menu. There is one more thing you need to take into consideration when using this mirror repeat option. So you've got a mirror design like I do here. You can then come into the layers window and you will realize we have one vector object. Yet we have 4 different assets on the artboard. Now this is a lot like the appearance panel where we can create many different design aspects from one vector object, but we can turn it into individual design components by clicking this bar at the very top and then ungrouping everything like so. So yeah, the sponsor of today's video is Skillshare. And Skillshare is an online learning community with millions of different users taking thousands of different classes. Now you can actually learn new skills or nurture existing passions or you might even discover a hidden talent that you might have. Now, I'm actually currently taking a course by Gustavo Torres, and I'm brushing up on my skills even though my routine is pretty jam-packed throughout each day. Now, Skillshare normally costs just less than $10 per month, but the first 1,000 people who click the link down below today and sign up to Skillshare will be granted a free trial to Skillshare Premium. So yeah, click the link down below and sign up to Skillshare and discover new skills today. Do let me know if you want to see more Illustrator content on this channel, and also click a video on screen if you want to learn more about graphic design. And until next time, guys, design your future today. Peace.